you'll see behind me, I have a computer. This is an Emachines computer, circa 2007, and it is factory loaded with Windows Vista. This machine has seen some trying times. There are a lot of bugs in this system. It's picked up a lot of junk along the way in its travels since it was built 6 years ago. And today, I'm going to do a full clean sweep, factory restore, reset, wipe, whatever you want to call it, and bring this computer back to the way it was the day it rolled off the assembly line. So let's get started. This machine, like many computers starting around the time this was built, has a restore partition in the hard drive. It doesn't come from the factory with any restore disks. So there's a trick to accessing the restore features of this computer. Don't you just hate those banner ads when you're using the computer that say, one weird trick to reduce your car insurance, or try this one sneaky tip to, you know, eat less at dinner time? I can't imagine why anyone would click on that. One weird, there's another one. What, Jennifer, tip, what's another word for tip? There's one sneaky tip they always talk about, and what's another word for tip? Like, hint? No. But you know what I'm talking about. Drive me nuts, though. Car insurance companies don't want you to know this one sneaky tip. Whatever. And somebody's going to say, oh. And then somebody gets up 10 cents for clicking the ad. But anyway, the trick for accessing the restore options. Trick, that's the other one. Trick. One weird trick for accessing the restore options on an Emachines computer, click here. The trick is, when you turn on the computer, you need to immediately start tapping the F8 button. And this should bring up a menu for the different factory reset and restore options on an Emachines or gateway computer. Remember the gateway computer, Cal computer? I think they built them in a dairy, and they used sweet cream soldering with those computers. So let's see if this works. And here we go, computer on. And just start tapping your trusty F8. Fate. We're pressing the fate button. You know how people say hate, skater, I hate snow? Boy, I learned a thing or two about Apple products. Red snow, snow breeze. That is a whole world of jargon and just what a learning curve on that stuff. I got a free iPhone in a box of junk and it didn't work, and I was sick last week, had the flu. So I had this iPhone and I wanted to make it work. So I started trying to figure out what was wrong with it, tried to jailbreak it. I had to worry about the blobs. You know about the blobs? I kind of know about the blobs, tiny umbrella, but anyway, needless to say, I didn't get the phone to work. But here we are on the restore screen. And what I want to click is the repair your computer, the top option. So now we wait. I adjusted the camera because it wants to lose focus on this screen. And that isn't a very good thing on a tutorial about the computer. So here we are. System recovery options, select keyboard layout. I didn't know there were other keyboard layouts. Norwegian and Polish, anyway. US, next. Then we log in as somebody. Administrator, whatever. Log into an account that it will let you log into. And then when we get to the system recovery options menu, go ahead and find the last option, recovery manager, and click that. This program allows you to recover your PC
if you severely mess it up beyond all recognition. Next, and we want full factory recovery with the special sauce and extra pickles. Next, all data will be lost. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes, data will be lost. You know, I started watching Lost on Netflix. I'm trying to hang with it. It's getting kind of out there, and I'm only on the first season so far. It seems like the writers just kind of don't know where the show's going themselves, and they just willy-nilly add another aspect to the story with no rhyme or reason. Like, let's throw in a pirate ship. Why not? So anyway, here it goes. Factory image recovery, and we'll see how it transpires here. One thing I was thinking about is when you start filming a show, writing a show for television, especially for the networks, it's likely that you don't know how long that show will last. So let's say their storyboard initially for Lost or any other given show was for it to last 2 seasons. They figured, here's the whole story laid out. This is going to happen, this is going to happen, and then it's done. Well, what happens if the ratings are huge? Everybody wants that show on year after year after year. You just have to squeeze it out, stretch it tighter and tighter. And I'm afraid that's what's going to happen with this show Lost that I started watching. I'm afraid things are going to get convoluted and really just kind of crummy television to watch. But that's the beauty of Netflix. I can turn it off when I want to. How's the image recovery coming? 41%. I'm reporting now horse race Emachines system recovery. I'm like the news reporting on the stock market. I'll tell you something. It doesn't make any sense for the news to report day-to-day activity on the stock market. And I'll tell you why. Any investor who concerns himself with day-to-day movement in the stock market has no business getting his information from the mainstream news. That person had better have some really up-to-date, comprehensive, paid-for info if they're working on the micro scale of day-to-day action, day trading on the stock market. And alternatively, the investor who would get their information from the news, why, he ought to be the type who just puts his money into a diversified account and forgets it. Don't worry about it every day because it's not a day-to-day make-money-lose-money proposition. We are in it for the long haul, so don't worry about it. But that's just the reason they report the stock market is because it's something to fill their yipper-yapper with between the kitty cat who fell out of the tree or somebody died or somebody else died. And, you know, when they're not chasing the ambulance, they can report on the stock market. And I'm doing the same thing here. Update on Emachines recovery tonight. We are now at 94% with 5 minutes remaining. Optimism is running high. Although there is some concern about the validity of this install. Brian, back to you in the newsroom. The newsroom. Have you seen those bloopers where they don't know the camera's on and they're cussing, F this, F that. There was it was actually a fake, but the guy was supposedly going to report on a dead girl and he said some obscene things about her. But the news is a racket. They prey upon your core emotions of sympathy, the train wreck complex. You can't help but watch the train wreck. And that's what they show on there. Those sympathy, train wreck, A little bit of pornography thrown in. They'll show some scantily clad. Recovery is complete. Finish, and it gave me some recommendations there that I'm not going to read. And now it's probably going to not focus. Stay with me, stay with me. Here's my hand. And let's just see what happens here. Let's see if we can boot up, boot out, and get some meaningful computing done. Oh, sorry, I wasn't staying with it. So now my focus is completely lost. You can't see what's on the screen either. Do the wave. So it is taking a long time to start up, which is worrying me, but... So it's preparing the computer to start for the first time. So there's a beautiful blue screen, Windows Vista, and now it focuses. Please wait. Okay. Personal trainers hate him. Weighs 95. Benches more than 95. Scientists in China have developed revolutionary new supplement. I mentioned trainers hate him. I hate those ads. But that's what keeps the internet running. That's what gives you rich content on the web, is funding from the goofy banner ad people. Well, this is getting tedious, folks. And The Lost is so TV drama, TV dramatic. Girl says, "Mr. Man, I'll tell you what I did in the past, if you want me to." Man says, "It doesn't matter. We all start over on the island." 5 minutes later, "I think I want to know what you did." "Too late. You had your chance. Nonsense. But that's why, you know, 20 something episode season, they gotta fill a lot of airtime there with interpersonal relationship issues. Oh, and we have a cursor. Time flies when you're talking nonsense. Everybody gets a factory reset on the island. Everyone. I know the show's 10 years old, but I'll tell you something. I don't have cable television. I don't even have a TV antenna for my TV. I don't have a TV antenna for my boat. So that's what I have to watch is Netflix streaming, $8 a month, which I split with somebody. But it doesn't matter. I tell myself, so what if I'm behind? That's why I buy old cars. I buy old cars that were nice in their day, because if I happened to be driving 10 years ago, I'd have the best car on the road. So I'm just delayed by a few years. Ooh, do you see that window? Wake up, wake up! It's like the camera has sleep in its eyes. It can't see. So here we are. Boy, that was a marathon. Welcome, Windows Vista Home Premium. This better not be another long wait. You had your time to do what you need to do. Oh, please wait while installing application 3 of 52. Okay. See you in a minute, fellas. I'm seeing these things that it's installing. I saw it install eBay desktop shortcut, internet security. So it's installing all the bloatware right now. I think I can see the actual case of the computer inflating. It's bloating as we speak. Anybody got any techie tums? Well, it took a while, but the install has completed. It took so long, in fact, that I took the opportunity to go have a shower, so I'm refreshed and ready for bed. We're here at the startup screen to set up Windows Vista, and I think the viewers at home can take it from here.
It looks like things are just about finished up here, and that's how to perform a factory restore on a Windows Vista equipped Emachines or Gateway computer. Now I just need to spend about an hour's worth of my time deleting all of the factory bundled garbage software that comes pre-installed on these machines. But I believe that I am up to the challenge. Thanks for watching.